This is the fat one, huh?
No, that's the fine one. No, the fat one is with me. Okay, we're live.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to Wildlife Safari from Jim Again Reserve in South Africa. And my name is Patrick, and Sebastian has joined me on camera this morning, and Mark in final control. Very beautiful morning, but it's still quite dark as you can see, and hopefully it will clear up and then we'll have a beautiful light. And yeah, I don't know where to start this morning. I'm just going to drive around quarantine and see if we can find anything around quarantine, and we'll take it from there. So please join us and enjoy the game drive. Impalas. They're busy chewing on the marilla fruits. They usually eat the yellow ones because the skin is softer than the green ones. And also the green ones are a bit bitter. Big mole walking across the road. There's quite a few moles in this herd. So they are walking in a single file. We are also sniffing the marula fruits. The most of them that are on the ground are green, so they're not ready to be eaten by impalas and the other animals. It takes about 2 or 3 days for the green marula fruits to turn yellow, and then they can be eaten by animals. But some will take longer than 3 days, depending on the weather. Elephants do eat both yellow and green ones, but they hardly chew the green ones. As I said, the skin is very, very tough.
I'm also making my way from Uhurut.
Henrik, come back. Henry, or Ephraim, come in. Alrighty. Henry, old friend coming. Bus stations. Station, come back. Yeah, I go. Yeah, affirmative.
Morning, this is Patrick from Wildlife Safari. Any update in the Western Circuit this morning? Confirm as the Ngala and the Bamba visible from Triple M itself. Okay, copy that. Thanks very much. Wally beast grazing on the southwestern edge of quarantine. There's a couple of youngsters lying down there. The others are busy feeding. So three youngsters and three adults. It's obviously the mothers and the babies. So they have split up. I don't know where the rest of the herd is. It might be up in the north and around Sydney's Dam or Cindy Page North. That's where they often hang around. Wallabies are predominantly grasses, and you wouldn't find them in the very thick vegetation areas. They prefer in the open grasslands. We don't have a massive wallaby's migration like you do see in the Masai Mara up in East Africa. Like you see the thousands and thousands of wallabies migrating from one country to another to go and look for better grazing areas as well as the water availability. They also migrate here, but in the smaller numbers of between 10 to 20 in the herd. So when there's a lack of food available in this part of the Sabisen, and they will migrate up to the north into Mnyeletu Reserve or in Belshoek or further down south of the Sabi Sands. And since the fences have been taken down, I've never seen an animals in a very, very bad conditions here, due to the lack of food source. So they have a free access of migration. They roam around wherever they like. Animals tend to Wake up in the very early hours of the morning and feed on a nice fresh grass and plants and leaves just before it gets too hot. So obviously when the temperature rises, and they will stop feeding and move down into some thick bushes to look for some shelter and take it easy for the day. Okay, let's move on. From come back. Morning to Kwana from Tamay on the Dalam Bamba. Guys, I'm moving off. Ngala is a mobile waste away from the Bamba. Okay, copy you 5-5 if are there any visual of Ngala state? Thank you.
come, come back.
Hyena was running over here. So running too fast, yeah? Baby elephant tracks, yeah. Just for the interest sake, and the three in Kahuma young males and killed up the buffalo. On Triple M south of Gowrie entrance gate. And apparently the carcass is right next to the road. On Simbambili side, and the lions have left the carcass and their mobile waste. And there is lots of vehicles making their ways to that area. So I don't think we will be able to go there this morning, so we'll try it this afternoon. bowing to the sun. You can hardly see the road. The plan for this morning, we're gonna scratch around Belsic Dam area, Chittacott line, and possibly head south towards Twin Dams, Gowrie Main Road at the area, and see what we can find. At the moment we are on that Belsic Gowrie cut line and just looking for any tracks coming in into Western Gowrie or going out of Western Gowrie. These animals tend to use the roads during the night, hunting and patrolling the territories. elephants. Looks like a breeding head. Morning jambos. It's one big ball here. The majority of the herd is slowly mobile to the southwest towards Mvubu Road. And the bulls are also following. Specimen elephant bull, this one. Just gonna quickly go around Mvubu Road and catch up with them before the cross over into the drainage line. You can see some other individuals making their way towards Gowri Dam. And they're fairly static in feeding now. Following the mother. It's beautiful, eh? Crossing over Mvubu Road, we're moving into Greenwich Line. Oh, there's a little baby, little one there. It's a tiny, tiny baby elephant. Wow. It's so cute, yeah? Some more coming through to your left. The big elephant bull still lagging behind the herd. Comes the big boss, Jumbo, Tembo, the gentle giant. There he goes. awesome. Couldn't come in Derby. Waste on Vibby Road, about 100 meters south of Bowery bus cut line. I still in Triple M. Dallas Bamba West, away from the Bamba. So how much Nyama is still on the carpet? After carpet, so they'll be there this afternoon. Gonna see if we can sneak through here and catch up with those elephants. Give you an update on the lions and on the buffalo kill. There's still a lot of meat on the carcass. Hopefully they will be there tonight. The grass very long, they can see the elephants static and feeding again. Try to go the other way. Good morning, madam. He's really a big boy, yeah. And he was standing right next to the vehicle in there. He's probably about just over 4 meters shoulder height. A wonderful sighting, yeah. It's a very special moment to be able to spend time with a breeding herd of elephants like this and so relax. There's the baby elephant. It's running, catching up with the mother. Awesome, is that? The bull was very close, eh? I was waving at him and he backed off. That big bull elephant suddenly realized that we are not posing any threat to them, especially to the little ones, because the elephants are very protective to the youngsters. And if you get too close to them, then they tend to get agitated. The balls are moving down to drainage line. And the rest of the head is moving west, parallel to the fire break. They're standing absolutely still now, so they are either listening to something or responding to the other individual elephants communicating with each other. There we go. Changing the direction now. Perhaps the my truck told him to move the other way, as they were moving completely the opposite way. this way. Young elephant cow doesn't like us. She's moving away from us. Two bulls are still behind us in the thick bushes and are invisible. One bull right in front of us, behind the bush, but he's slowly moving out of the thicker bush. The problem is the sun, it's shining directly into the camera. You walk through the spider web and destroy it completely. Moving deep into the thick bushes and we won't be able to keep up with them, unfortunately. So I think we should leave them in peace and see what else we can find. We're going to be cutting away because Sebastian Romy lost the control of the camera, and he can't do anything. He can't change any settings, and so we're just going to quickly reboot the system and see how it goes, and hopefully we'll be back to you as soon as possible. Bye for now.
Morning everyone, Mark here in Final Control. Thank you for your patience. We have rebooted the system a few times. We seem to not be able to get control of the camera, and it looks like if it's not going to work this umpteenth time that we're rebooting, we're going to be bringing the vehicle back to camp, trying to sort out the issue here at camp. Thank you very much for bearing with us, and well, let's see what we've got at Gowrie Dam in the meantime, other than the hippo.
Tracking the crocodile, the largest reptile in Africa. We took a shortcut through the grass there. Back on the road again. Cut through the grass here again. We are here at Twin Dams. Let's see if the crocodile is here. The tracks went straight into the water. Quite windy and cold now, so he should be under the water just to keep himself warm. Just gonna go around the other side of the dam wall and see if we can find some tracks. no tracks on this road. So it's definitely twin dams. No movement around Baboon's Pen either. Looks like the clouds are building up in the south. Might have some rain, possibly this afternoon. It's definitely rain clouds coming in from the southeast. Let's go ahead and have a look around at Treehouse Dam. It's already after closing down time. I'm just gonna give it some few minutes and say goodbye to you folks and head back to the basin. And I'm not happy about something in there. didn't see anything yet. Horace are also shouting the vanish line. Okay, I'm going to say goodbye, and we'll see how it goes this afternoon. As I said, with this a buffalo kill just off Triple M near Gowrie Gate, so that's basically the plan for this afternoon. So we're going to head straight there just before the game drive vehicles start mobile, so that we can have at least in half an hour to an hour sighting to ourselves. And just thanks very much for joining us and asking some questions. So it has been a great morning, and we might have some rain during the course of the day or later tonight, so we'll see how it goes, and then we'll obviously keep you guys posted. And my name is Patrick Seb, behind the camera, and Mark back in file control, and we'll see you later this afternoon. Bye for now.